Hello, I'm the developer of the plugin that is called Extended Graph, and I will try to do a series of videos that will hopefully help anyone that wants to use it to understand how it works and showcase a little bit of the feature that it can do. So first of all, I apologize in advance for the accent that I have and the probable mistakes that I will make. English is not my native language, and I might blank sometimes just because I'm searching for the words and or like go back in time for what I just said because I realize it's a mistake. I will add captions, like subtitles, at the bottom of like in the video. Hopefully it will help you to follow if you don't understand, but hopefully it will be enough. So one thing that should be said about this plugin is it adds a lot of features, and because of that it can be really heavy and make like some performance issues. That's why I'm not, if you install the plugin and just expect it to change something, it won't. You have to enable it and deal with all of that by yourself, because I don't want to burn anyone's GPUs or CPUs. You will be the responsible one for that. To enable the plugin in a graph view, you should see an icon in the top right corner that has been added under the two icons that are already there. If you don't see it, please just relaunch the Obsidian app. If you just installed the plugin, it might need one relaunch before loading. And if you click on it, by default, if you have more than 20 nodes currently enabled in the graph view, it will not allow the plugin to be enabled. This is because of the performance reasons, and I have no idea what are the performances of your computer. I know I'm running on something that is sufficient to handle hundreds of nodes. You might not. So by default, if you have more than 20, it won't work. To change that, you can probably either open a local graph that is smaller, or go in the performances sections at the bottom of the settings, and here in the maximum number of nodes, make it as high as you need, while thinking that if you go like for 8,000, you might have issues. So I will go for 100 because I know it's enough for this vault. And now I can enable it. I see that it's enabled because the button has changed here, the color, and there are two buttons that have been added, but it's not doing anything. And that is because the plugin has a lot of features, and the reason you might want to use this plugin might be different from someone else. At first, I was enabling by default all of the features that I'm using, and now I'm using maybe like 20% of the features. So I just realized that it didn't make any sense to enable some of them by default and not others. So I just don't enable on any of them, and you have to pick the one that you want. I will go later, like delve deeper in the explanation of all of those features, all of the settings, but for now, just to show that it's working, I will enable the images and the tags. You can pick every time like the global or the local graph because of the different, like the difference of size of your graphs. Anyways, I'm working on the global graph right now, so it should be enough. And now I can reset the plugin with the arrow or just disable and then enable it again. And you will see that pictures have been added inside the nodes, and now you see some tags here. So those are like the color of the tags, and more especially you can active the like show display the legend, and you will see each tag has one color, and Yeah, the color is the same as the arc. I will show options to display that in another way that is better, but to, if you don't like, to show it better, all of those tags not are now of a different color than the default tag color, and it's because like the expert is green, the detectives are orange and stuff like that. So this shows that the plugin is working with at least two of the features. Now, what you might want to do, let's disable that for a moment. Here, I just installed this vault, it's a fresh vault, so I haven't done any modification to the grab view, but you might use Obsidian for a while and maybe you have some settings that you're used to. Like, let's say you're used to show attachments and tags, for example. And maybe you have some filters here. If you enable the grab view, it will reset that to the default settings of the grab view. And it's because if you enable this little eye here, you will see that it's because you're using the default state. The default state is meant to be, well, the default settings of the app. You might want to change your default settings to the one that you already like. So you see, by default, because in Obsidian you don't have any tags or attachments that are shown, the default state don't have that either. Now you have two options to synchronize all of that. The word and the keywords that I'm using are native state for the graph when the plugin is not enabled and default state for when the plugin is enabled and you're like in this current view. You can, in these options here, you can decide to save these settings currently used for the default state. So for example, if I display tags and save this for the default state, I disable the plugin, I enable it again, and now the tags are shown. If I decide to save this for the native state, because maybe I found like a new setting arrangement that I like and I want to save that, let's say for example I find out that I want to modify the forces a little bit, something like that, and I save that for the native state, if I disable the plugin, it will stay like that. But it's not saved for the default state yet. So if I enable that, wink, I'm back to the default settings for this. Now there is, so you can do either manually, like click every time you change something, or you can go here in the automation block and enable the synchronized default state. That means that every time you, let's say you have your plugin disabled and this option is enabled, if you enable the plugin, these settings will be saved for the default state. Here you see the default state has been saved and the settings hasn't changed. So you're still having the forces that you set, the tags are showing, the attachments are not, and stuff like that. So this is one of the automation that is possible. Another automation that you might be interested in is to enable the graph enable the plugin by default when you open the graph. So let's say I'm closing the graph view, I open it, I have to click there to enable that. Now, if I auto-enable the plugin and I close this tab and I open the graph view, boom, the plugin is enabling itself and I don't have to click it. Now, I might want to maybe filter out some of the tags here. So let's say I don't want most of them and I just want to see the active and the closed case. So this is the poison case, the park murder and the mall break-in. Two of them are active, one of them is closed. Now, if I close or disable the plugin or close this tab and come back to it later, it will not show this filter It will show everything. I need to save this as a state. So for example, I would call that closed and active cases. I'm saving that, and now if I go back to the default, as I said, everything is showing up. If I go back to the closed and active states, only the closed and active state are showing up. Maybe most of the time I will always want to see this state that I just managed and set up. In that case, I might want to modify this option, that a starting state shouldn't be the default state anymore, but be the closed and active cases. So let's close this. And then I open the GraphView, it enables the plugin, and it switches to closed and active cases on its own. Okay. Secondly, the closed and active cases, if I just disable the tags, it won't make sense anymore because, well, you don't have any filtering that is happening because you removed the feature of the tags. So one thing that can be done is importing and exporting all of those settings. So if you, for example, if you want a certain view that filter on the properties and the leaks, and a certain view that had tags and shapes, and another view that uses icons and links as statistics and stuff like that, you might want to use different configurations, and you might want to bind those configurations to each state. You don't have to bind them, you can just export the current one or import one that you previously exported. But you might want to, for example, always use this configuration with the tags enabled when you use the closed and active cases. For that, you need to enable the save configuration with state. And you also need to remove the auto enable and and the static state, put it back to default, because if you don't, you will load a certain configuration while trying to change it, but it will cancel the changes that you've made. So yeah, we don't want that here. So let's say I'm using the tags. Okay, perfect. Closed and active cases, and then I'm saving that. Now, in the import section, I should see that I have, I had another one just before, but I have a new state that is called closed and active cases. And if I disable the tags here, I disable the plugin, enable it again, I'm on the default state. You see I'm not using any tags, the legend is not showing up, and now I'm switching to closed and active states. And the configuration is it's reloading, and then I have all the tags that are active or disabled for some of them. Be careful that if you have big vaults, every time you need to reload a new configuration, the plugin has to be fully reloaded in the current graph view, because there are so many like initialization process that are dependent on the option that you use, that you chose, which means that if you change one setting, it has to reload everything. And by the way, another automation that might be interesting for you is this one. So let's say, for example, not using this anymore, I want to enable the link types and maybe disable the images. I'm there, I need to disable and then enable it again, and you see now I have link types that are colored and I don't have any images anymore, but I do need to click there every time. One thing that you can do is enable that with that GraphView after changes, which means that if you do any changes in these options, it will, as soon as you close this model, it will reset the GraphView with the new options in any GraphView where the plugin is currently enabled. So I remove the link types and I add the images back. Okay, it's reloaded. You might see the color, they didn't disappear right away. You might just like move a little bit to force the graph to re-render, to render once more, and it should disappear. Yes, so those are the automation. The last automation that I didn't mention, what it's a little bit different, is this one. Let's remove all of them. Open node in a new type. By default, I know that you can just right-click and do open in a new tab here, or you can do a will click and it will open in a new tab. But you can also, maybe you want to always open on a new tab and never close the graph whenever you're using it, when you're using the global graph to navigate in your nodes. So you can enable this option here. And if you enable the graph, the plugin in this graph view, and you do a simple left click, it will open the node in a new tab. I don't, yeah, you can see, but I did a left click and not a will click. So yeah, that's about it for all of the automation process. One advice that I would give is before doing any of those automation, just make sure you have the settings and the options as you want them, because it's kind of hard to modify when there are automation going on, because they might cancel what you just did before. So make sure you have everything set up as you want, and once it's done and you are tired of just clicking like one or two click every time you need to open the graph view, just go and do the automation steps. So yeah, that's about it. Next, I will go in the tags property and link types to go through everything that is possible to filter, like dynamically filter the graph view and remove nodes or links.